Hello, my friends. I am Emine Esin Ünlü. I am your English language teacher. Today, we are going to start the first unit, Friendship. You see here personal traits. Do you know personal traits? Personal traits mean personal characteristics. There are two ways of personal characteristics. One of them is good, and the other one is bad. If you have a good personal characteristics, everyone likes you, and you have got a lot of friends around you. But if you have a bad personal trait, you don't have a lot of friends, and anybody doesn't like you, you are always alone. It's a negative meaning. You see here good personal traits. First of all, it's honest. If you are an honest person, you always tell the truth. You never tell a lie. Reliable. If you are a reliable person, you keep your friends' secrets and you never share them with others. Generous. If you are a generous person, you share your money with the people, especially the people in need. Amusing. If you are an amusing people, you make people around you smile and happy. Caring and tactful, synonyms, so they have the same meaning. If you are a person, a caring person or a tactful person, you always think about others and you worry about them. Determined, if you are a determined person, first you are ambitious and you will do everything. For example, you study hard, you work hard to reach your aim, to reach your goal. Helpful and supportive. Helpful and supportive have the same meaning. They are synonyms too, like the others. If you are a helpful or a supportive person, you give encourage, backup, and support your friends. And the last one, loyal. If you are a loyal person, the only thing is for you, friendship. You never give up your friendship for anything. Now, you can see bad personal traits. These are adjectives. Now, today we are going to learn these. Unreliable. If you are an unreliable person, you always tell a lie and anybody doesn't believe you. Arrogant. If you are an arrogant person, you think that you are more important than your friends. Bad-tempered and aggressive have the same meaning. They are synonyms. If you are a bad-tempered or an aggressive person, you cannot get on well with your friends and you always argue with them. Mean. If you are a mean person, you never share your money. You always keep it. Stubborn. If you are a stubborn person, you never change your idea and you cannot say yes easily. Jealous. If you are a jealous person, you will get angry and you will feel upset when you see your friend is interested in anybody. Sneaky. Sneaky is a person who always does all the things in a secret way, but nobody knows. Laid back. If you are a laid back person, you relax in all manners. And the last one, self-centered. If you are a self-centered, you only think about yourself, but not others. My friends, be careful about these kind of questions, because in the exam you will see like this. Questions about friendship. What characteristics should an ideal friend have? Characteristics mean personal traits. What are the personal traits of a good friend to you? A good friend means best friend and ideal friend. Who is your best friend? What makes her or him special? What other things do you like doing with your friends? What do you like doing with your friends? Be careful about these kinds of questions. Okay, Which of the following is not related to Erika's personal traits? We should be careful about this kind of questions because there is not in the question form. If not given in the question form, we should give the wrong information. Now, Erika is me. We understand that she doesn't spend money, she doesn't share her money. Erika is funny. We can understand that she amuses and she makes jokes. Adventurous is a kind of person who is interested in unusual things, different or hard things, for example, extreme sports, bungee jumping, skydiving. And honest, you know honest, always tells the truth. Now look at the options. The first option, A, Erika enjoys sharing her money with her friends. Share her money is our keyword. If somebody shares your money with you, she is generous. But according to the given information, she is not generous, she is mean. So this option is false. B, she never tells lies and always keeps her friends' secrets. Tell a lie and never tell a lie and keep secrets are our keywords. If someone never tells and keeps secrets, she is honest. C, it is correct. C, Erika is a funny person. She always makes people happy. If someone makes people happy, it is funny. It is correct. Two, she enjoys doing hard activities. She thinks they are exciting. Hard activities means adventurous activities. So it is correct. A is false because we should find wrong information. I don't like Melinda. She never gives me money when I need. To me, she is blah, blah, blah. Here is keyword, give money. But be careful because there is never here. If someone gives money, she is generous. If someone never gives you money, she is not generous. She is mean. So the answer is mean. D is correct. Read the speech bubble and answer the question. Which of the following is not correct according to the comics above? We should be careful because we will find the correct information. Hey, Martin, what do you think about Jason? Is he one of your close friends? Oh, no, we don't get on well with each other. I don't count him. Our keywords are get on well with and count on him. But be careful, my friends, because we use these words with negative form. Okay, be careful here. Now, A, Jason and Martin are close friends. Is it true? No, they are not close friends because he said that they don't get on well with each other. It is false. Martin thinks that Jason is an unreliable person. Is it true? Unreliable is our keyword. Yes, it is true. Because he said that he doesn't count on him. So, B is correct. Look at the other choices. Jason is a self-centered and sneaky person. There is no information about self-centered and sneaky. D, Martin doesn't like Jason because he is jealous. There is again no information about jealous. So, B is correct answer. Sue is my best friend because she is blah, blah, blah. She always supports me. Support here is our keyword. If someone supports you, she helps you and backs you up. So she is helpful or supportive. Now look at the circumstances. Here, helpful, arrogant, adventurous, amusing. So A is correct because there is no information about the other choices. text and answer the question. Which of the following cannot be Mr. Robin's speech bubble? Be careful about my friends because we will find wrong information. Because not here, you see not here, so we will find the wrong and false information. Okay. Mr. Robertson is Oliver's grandfather, and he is giving some advice about good personality traits. He thinks a person should be honest, supportive, generous, and loyal. Our keywords are honest, supportive, generous, and loyal. Now, look at options. A, you shouldn't tell a lie. If someone shouldn't tell a lie, he should be what? Honest, yes. A is correct. B, you should back your friends up. Back up means support, help. So, supportive is here. B is correct. C, you should think of only yourself. If somebody thinks of only yourself but not others, we say this. Self-centered. But there is no information about self-centered. So, D, you should share your things with your friends. If you share your things with your friends, you are a generous person. Yes, here is the information. So, C is correct because it is false and there is no information about self-centered person. Mom, why don't you go out with Paul, Bob? To me, he is blah, blah, blah. He always tells lies to me and my friends. Here is tell a lie and always telling a lie is our keyword. If someone tells you always tell a lie, he is not a reliable person. He is an unreliable person or a dishonest person. Look at the choices. Yes, you can find here he is an unreliable person because he is always telling lies. Okay, according to the information above, who thinks Kila is not bad-tempered? Bad-tempered means, you know, has got a negative meaning. But be careful, my friends, not bad-tempered here, negative, negative means positive meaning. So we should find good-tempered. Okay, now look at the information. He is always relaxed in manners. We can understand that when somebody is relaxed in manners, he is laid back. Valerie, he always keeps my secrets. If someone keeps your secrets, he is reliable. Nina, he gets on well with his friends. If someone gets on well with your friends, he is good-tempered. Like this. And the last one, Bill, he backs me up when I am in trouble. If someone backs you up and helps you, he is very helpful and supportive. Because of this, you can find good-tempered and good-tempered here. Nina is the correct answer. B is correct, my friends. Okay, according to the information above, who thinks Paul is a stubborn person? Let's remember stubborn. Stubborn. Stubborn is a person who never changes his mind or decisions or never say yes easily. Remember this, please. Okay, Angela. He always does his homework. If he always does his homework, he is hardworking. Bella, he never changes his decisions or mind. He is stubborn. And Kathy, he always makes me laugh. If somebody makes you laugh, he is very amusing. And Fred, never tells lies. If someone never tells a lie, he is honest. So, Bella B is correct. because stubborn means never change his mind and decisions. My friends, be careful about these words because they are synonyms and you will see in the exam these words too much. Trust, count on, depend on, rely on have the same meaning. Give encouragement, back up, help and support have the same meaning too. They are synonyms. If you get on well with somebody, you never argue. If you have a good friendship, you also have a good relationship. If you have lots of things in common, you have the same interests and hobbies. Again, I want you to be careful in the exam. When you see these words, you can understand passages very easily. Now, you see here events and activities. In this unit, we are going to learn how to invite somebody to somewhere. So we will learn these words in advance. Birthday party, you know birthday party. Slumber, pijama, and sleepover party. They have the same meaning. For example, if you go to one of your friend's house and you stay there all the night and you sleep, it means sleepover party, okay? Wedding ceremony. When you get married, you have a wedding ceremony. Your guests come and you invite them. Barbecue. You grill meat or chicken. Okay. Graduation party. When you finish your school, you have a graduation party. Fancy dress party and costume party have the same meaning. School picnic, you know. Sports tournaments. Family reunion, class reunion. Reunion means meet again after a long time. You meet your family members or you meet your classmates after a long time. Beach party, rock concert, and book fair. I think you know these kinds. Okay. Who is an appropriate friend for him? Appropriate friend, true friend, or ideal friend? Now, Henry wants to have a friend in class. He doesn't want anyone stubborn and self-centered around him. He also dislikes discussing with his friends. According to him, having a good relationship is important among friends. Henry also pays attention to trust and wants his friend to share everything with him. Trust and share everything with him, our keywords. Now, A, Nikki. Nikki is reliable and generous. Look at here. Is he reliable? Yes, he is reliable. Is he generous? Yes, he shares his things with other things with his friends. It is correct. But let's check other answers. B, Vilma. Stubborn. Does he like stubborn people? No, he doesn't like because he said that he doesn't want anyone stubborn around him. He is honest, but this is false. Bad-tempered. We can see here, he also dislikes discussing with people. Bad-tempered people, you know, always argue and discuss their friends. It is false. And mean is false also, because he likes generous people, not mean people. And Donna, supportive and self-centered. There is no information about these words. So A is correct. Okay, which of the following is related to Burak's personality? Self-centered. Who is self-centered? Self-centered, the person who only thinks about himself. Thinks about himself. Stubborn. Who is stubborn? Stubborn is a person who always never says yes and he never changes his mind. Snob. Snob is a person who always looks down the people around him, and determined is a person who is very ambitious and tries to do everything to reach his or her aim. Adventurous, you know, adventurous is a person who is interested in extreme sports. And jealous, you know, jealous is a person who gets angry and gets feel upset when he or she sees her friend with another person. Now, look at these options, please. A, attaches importance to his friends and never forgets their important days. According to the given information, when somebody gives importance to you, we can understand that he is tactful and caring person. B, he never tells lies and keep our secrets, so all his friends count on him. If somebody never tells lie and keep on our secrets, we can count on him. It means honest person, reliable person. C, doesn't change his mind easily and only thinks about himself. You know, if somebody doesn't change his mind easily, we can tell. And only thinks about himself, self-centered. Yes, there is here information, self-centered and stubborn. C is correct, but look at the last one. Sometimes argue with his friends, and most of the time he gets on well with them. First of all, he is bad-tempered, and then he is good-tempered, but there is no information about these words. So answer is C. My friends, we are going to learn today and next lesson how to make decision, how to invite somebody to somewhere. Okay. Would you like? Would you like means do you want? But there is a little difference between them. Would you like is more formal than do you want? There are two rules in here. Some more cake is noun. When we use would like to with a noun, we don't use to. We only use noun like this. There is not to. But would you like to go to the cinema with us? Or would you like to have dinner with me tonight? Go to and have dinner are verbs. If verbs are here, we should combine it with to in would you like sentence. We should use to verb one. Let's give an example. An apple is not a verb, it's only a noun. So we don't use to. Would you like an apple? Yes or no? You can answer. But we can say, would you like to eat an apple? When we use eat is here verb. When we use it, we should use to. Okay? When you don't use verb, we don't use to. Okay? Is it clear? Yes. Yes, the same rule. We can see here the same rule. Do you want to? If we use some fruit juice is a noun. We don't use to. We use only noun. But if you want to use watch, attend, have, we should use to with a verb. In summary, when we use noun, we don't use to in do you want or would you like, but when we use a verb, we have to use to go, to come, to attend, like this. Okay? How about, what about, have the same meaning? How about and what about, but you should be careful because we use verb with ing form. For example, how about throwing? How about go, going? There is no subject in this type. my friends. You can see here and you can look at here. Don't walk behind me, I may not lead. Don't walk in front of me, I may not follow. Just walk beside me and be my friend. Albert Camus. Now, playtime. I prepared this puzzle for you. We are going to play it here, but if you want to play it at home, you can download it from our website, Sparta Map, and you can play it with your family members. If you want to learn English, if you want to speak English, you should play games. Playing games will help you to remember the words easily. Now, there is a rule here. It is very easy. You will match the words with their meanings correctly. First one is English and the second one is Turkish. You will correct them easily. Yardımsever, what does it mean in English? Yardımsever, helpful. Okay, kind, what does it mean in Turkish? Kind, kibar, you can see here. Okay, and honest, what does it mean in Turkish? Honest mean? Dürüst, yes. Okay, we find it at last. Jealous. What does it mean? Jealous. Kıskanç. Okay. Stubborn. What does it mean in Turkish? Stubborn. İnatçı. Yes. Okay. Mean. What does it mean in Turkish? Mean. Cimri. Okay. Generous. You know generous. Cömert in Turkish. Yes. Tell a lie. What does it mean in Turkish? Tell a lie. Yalan söylemek. Yes. Class reunion. Okay. Yes. Bad-tempered and iyi-huylu. The same meaning. Class reunion. Sınıf birlikteliği. The same meaning. Düğün töreni. Wedding ceremony. Yes. Costume party. We will find costume party. Yes. It is correct. Beach party. Plaj partisi. Yes, it is correct now. Pijama partisi, slumber party, you know. Doğum günü partisi, birthday party. Arrogant, kibirli, kötü huylu, bad-tempered. Okay. And the last one, graduation party, mezuniyet partisi. My friends, thank you. Time's up today. See you next lesson. Bye.